Are you tired of paint that fades back or washes away after heavy rain? Today, I'll show you how to make weather-resistant paint, a powerful formula that withstands rain, UV rays, humidity, and extreme temperature changes. Stay with me to the end for a complete step-by-step guide. So let's get started. First, let's understand what weather-resistant paint is. Weather-resistant paint is also known as weather sheet, weather guide, or rain sheet paint. This specialized paint forms a protective barrier against harsh environment conditions, and it is commonly used on exterior walls or feathers to prevent rain and sun damage, roof and gutters to stop leakage and rust, metals and wood surfaces to prevent corrosion and rot, bridges and infrastructures to enhance durability and lifespan. So anytime you hear the word weather sheet, weather guide, weather pro, weather tech, weather whatever it is, it's still weather resistant paint. So don't get yourself confused. So now let's understand the types of weather resistant paint and their benefits. Yes, if you're not aware, there are different types of weather resistant paint. So number one, we have acrylic exterior paint, weather resistant, flexible, UV resistant, and durable, preventing cracks. Two, we have elastomeric paint, thick and waterproof, perfect for heavy rain exposure. Three, we have silicone-based weather-resistant paint, highly water-repellent and resistant to mud and mildew. Then the fourth types of weather-resistant paint is oil-based weather-resistant paint. Yes, provide strong adhesion and durability. The fifth one is epoxy weather-resistant paint, best for metal surfaces, offering rust and chemical resistance. So these paints share key functions, which are waterproofing, UV protection, mud resistance, and long-lasting durability. Now let's move on to the real deal, how to produce your own weather-resistant paint. But first of all, like you all know, I like to explain chemicals and their functions for better understanding. So to make professional grade weather resistant paint, you'll be needing specific chemical. So let's go through them and their roles. One, water, 6 liters, forms 25% of the paint composition. Two, carbonate, 10 kg, adds body and structure. 3, titanium dioxide, 2 kg, improves opacity and coverage. 3, acrylic, 10 kg, enhance adhesion and sheen. The next chemical is texanol, 500 gram, enhance even mixing, and of course, this is a coalescent agent. The other chemical is your carbon PT, 50 gram. Breaks down the pigment into finer particles. And of course, we have the biocide, which is 100 gram. Extend life shelf by preventing bacterial growth in the paint, especially those of us that are reselling this paint. So, and under this biocide, we have formalin and articide. You understand? Your articide form under incan preservative, while your formalin, it's another preservative as well. So then we have ammonia, 50 gram, speeds up depressions, and of course it's reduced the alkaline in the paint. And of course we have genipol. Usually is not advisable to add to this weather resistant paint, but it's good for you to add it. Why? It's because of the calcium carbonate, so your paint don't block over time. So this genipol works as a wetting agent for smoothening application. Then of course we have defoamer, 200 gram, prevent bubbles in paint. We all know the functions of defoamer, which is your anti-foamer. So we have nitrosol, 200 gram, increase viscosity and thickness. Then of course we have the caustic soda solution, 20 gram. Yes, the reason we'll be using 20 gram of caustic soda formulation is because, you know, caustic soda adjusts the pH level, which is the same work for ammonia, but caustic soda also have another function, which is under the plasticizers, just like your carbon PT acts as a plasticizer. You understand? So the function of plasticizers is that it helps the paint not to crack on the wall. You understand? So of course we have Caroline clay, which is your 500 gram. This enhance opacity and coverage. Then we have the tack powder, which is on 500 gram, act as a refined filler. You understand? And of course it's a waterproofing agent. Then we have your EPW paste, very essential, 200 gram, protects against agri or bacteria or mud or fungi. You understand? Then of course we have color pigment, of course your color of choice, you understand, because you're going to be producing a color paint. But if you want to produce white water resistant white weather resistant paint, there is another process we use for production of white paint, especially when it comes to weather resistant paint. You have to treat your water, and of course you have to use your hydrosol to make the white paint very brightish, and of course you have to use your whitener. You understand? So the way we produce the colored weather resistant paint is far different from when you're producing white weather resistant paint. And of course you have to add your aluminium silicate, you understand? So there are other chemicals you're going to add, but the production process is the same. The chemicals used for the color weather resistant paint is the same with the white resistant paint. It's just that we're not going to be using our color pigment, you understand? We're only going to be using titanium dioxide, and we are also going to use these other three chemicals which I just mentioned. And of course we're going to be using our Caroline clay white. And if you notice, the Caroline clay here is 500 gram. The reason is because I want you to achieve your desired color. Caroline clay at times make you not to get the desired color you want to use for your paint production. And of course when you have your color scent agent add to it, which is your Texano, it helps prevent the color from fading from wall. You understand? So now that we have our chemical listed, let's jump straight into the production process. So step one, pour in 6 liters of water into a mixing container and add your Cargon PT and stir. Slowly add your titanium dioxide, your tack powder, your calcium carbonate, then mix for about 20 minutes. Step four, dissolve your nitrosol in a separate water in can, then add it to the main mixture. Mix for another 10 minutes. You understand? Please take note, mix for another 10 minutes. Then why the step five, you add your ammonia and mix for 5 minutes. So after adding your ammonia, you add your genipur, you add your deformer, and you add your biocide. This biocide, remember please, whenever you are making use of your articide, do not use formalin, please. If you're making use of your articide, beautiful, you can make use of your ammonia. But if you're making use of your formalin, then please don't add your articide, you understand? So after that, you add your EPW paste, and then you add your Texano, and of course you add your MEG, you understand? And your acrylic should be last. Yes, this is a different production process. The reason why your acrylic is last is because it is a weather resistant paint. So we want the acrylic to be able to combine all the chemicals together, and of course make it more durable, and do not let other chemicals to interfere the acrylic, you understand? Because this is a weather resistant paint, and we want the acrylic to be able to perform the functions very well, you understand? And there you have it with your weather resistant paint. And of course be ready to use it on your walls, roof, and not really metal surfaces, you understand? Because I'm also going to create a video on weather resistant metal surfaces paint, so you can also have that formulation. So if you find this tutorial valuable, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more paint making secrets. And of course turn on your notifications so you never miss exclusive discounts on our professional paint making courses. And if you have any question or you want more tutorial like this, just drop it in the comment section. I'll be glad to help out, you understand? So until next time, creating, and bye for now.